Hello everyone, I have started a new video series on the topic flowering plants. In my last few videos, I discuss in detail about the different organs which is present in the flowering plant and different regions which is there in the roots of angiospermic plant or the flowering plants. The five important regions which is present in the root are root cap region, then region of cell division, cell elongation region, root ear region and maturation region. So these five regions play important role in the root of angiospermic plant. Now in this video, I'm going to talk about the different types of the root which is there in the flowering plants. So we can easily differentiate two types of root system which is present in these plants. The first type of root system which is quite developed one is called as tap root system. While the second type of the root which is present in this type of plant is adventitious root system. So in this video, I am going to discuss in detail about these two type of root which is present in the flowering plants. First is tap root. They are also called as true roots. And adventitious root also called as false root. So the first characteristic feature of the tap root system is that this type of roots develop from radical at the time of seed germination. Okay, while adventitious roots are developed from any other part except radical. Okay, so this type of roots are generally developed from any other parts of the plant like stem or leaves, but they do not develop from the radical. So what is radical? If we break open the seed of dicotyledon plant, we can easily observe two cotyledons. Okay, so this is the structure of the dicot seed. If we break open the seed, we can see two cotyledon connected with each other by thin band like structure. Now this thin band like structure which connecting the two cotyledon is called as cotyledonary band. Now if we observe this cotyledonary band carefully, we can see two points. The upper point which is grow out of the soil is called plumule, while lower point which grow down in the soil is called as radical. If we consider this middle portion of this band as cotyledonary band. Now the region, this is radical and the upper portion is plumule. The region of this band which is present in between cotyledonary band and radical is called hypocotyle. And the region of this band which is present in between plumule and this band is called epicotyle. Epi means above and cotyle means cotyledon. So this region is present above the cotyledon, while hypo means below and cotyle means cotyledons. So this region of the band is generally present below the cotyledons. So this is the basic structure which is present at the time of seed germination. And in this structure, we can see two points, radical and plumule. The tap root or true root always develop from this radical at the time of seed germination. Okay, so we have written that this root develop from the radical, but adventitious roots always develop from any other part of the plant body like stem or leaves. They do not develop from the radical. Why this happened? Because adventitious root are the characteristic feature of monocot plants. That means monocrop plant generally show adventitious root, and radical in the monocrop plant degenerate or disappear. Very small radical is present in the seed of monocrop plant, and it disappear at the time of seed germination. So generally this plant do not have a radical, so that they develop root with the help of root stem, okay, or leaves. So we call this type of root as adventitious root or false root. Okay, as we call taproot as a true root, so we can also call adventitious root as false root. And as this adventitious root is the characteristic feature of monocot plant, taproot is characteristic feature of dicot plants. That means dicot plant generally show taproot or true root systems. Okay, examples of dicot plant, we know that radish, then pimple, or the big trees who generally show the taproot system, and their root grow deep in the soil. Okay, so all the type of dicot plant show this type of root system, while monocot plants like sugarcane or maize, then wheat, show this type of root system, which do not grow deep in the soil. They remain on the upper portion of the soil. Okay, now the next important characteristic feature of the taproot system is that they show branches. Here you can see from the stem in the soil, a first longest, strongest and thickest branch arise. This longest branch is called as primary root. Then from primary root, first order branches expressed, or from primary root, this first order branches develop. They are called as secondary root. And from secondary root, you can see many small branches arise, which are nothing but the tertiary root. So dicot plants, taproot system show different type of roots, okay, like primary root, secondary root and tertiary root. The main branch which arises from the base of the stem, which is longest, strongest and thickest, is called as primary root. Then the branches of the first order which develop from the primary root is called secondary root, while the branches of the second order which develop from the secondary root are called tertiary root. In case of adventitious root or false root, we are unable to see the differentiation of the branches like taproot. In case of this type of root system, cluster of the roots arise from the base of the stem. They are generally hair like thin roots of equal sizes. Okay, so this appearance is look like fibrous. So many roots in the grass show fibrous appearance, and this type of root system also called as fibrous root. Okay, because they do not show differentiation of the branches like primary, secondary and tertiary. So this is the third important characteristic feature of taproot and adventitious root system. So in this video, we discuss in detail about the taproot system, which is present in the dicot plant, and adventitious root system, which is present in the monocot plant. In my next video, I'm going to start with the different type of modifications which is present in both this type of root system, because plant have to modify their root to perform some special functions. So from my next video, I'm going to focus on modifications. Thank you.